Hey boys, hey girls, welcome to Louisiana Cajun Recipes. Today I'm gonna smoke some beef ribs, a little slab ribs, with the bones. And I've got this little product here. It's a Smartro cooking thermometer. It's brand new. Came with instructions and other pamphlets and papers. And it says if you write a review for them, they'll give you a free probe. It comes with two. This does not have a remote app, but it's simple to set. I was able to set it without even reading the instruction. It's got two magnets on back for hanging on metal stuff. It takes two AAA batteries. Got a little hanging place there, and it got a little stand to stand up on the countertop. See that? If you want to, or on something on the side, like a shelf on the side of your grill or smoker. And it's just, keep it simple, stupid, easy to set. And I'm gonna go ahead and set it up for like 250. Cook temperature and about 135 on the probe that I'm gonna stick in the rib. And I'm gonna use my little Weber kettle. It's just simple and easy. So that's what I'm gonna do. It's also got a countdown timer on it too. You can set two different timers if you attempting to cook by time, which you should not barbecue by time, by the way. You should always go by temperature, preferably grate temperature, which this one comes with a little clip to clip on your grates, and the probe slips through it, and you can get your cooking grate temperature, which is important. And this dome temperature don't mean nothing. If you got a thermometer up in the top, that's not what the cooking grate is. It's gonna be different. Now, you know, like in a Weber Smoky Mountain, I like to drop a ambient temperature probe down between both grates. I drop it in from the vent. I measure it on the side of the smoker first, see where that position is, and just drop it down in there. And it reads the temperature between both cooking grates, which is pretty good way to do it. Let me get my ribs out, salt and pepper. And we go try this little Smartro thermometer out. And oh, when you get it, the probes are gonna come wrapped up. Make sure you don't let them kink. When you go to straighten them, make sure there's, in other words, they're not twisted or in a knot, because that can damage the internal wire that's in there. And this thing is rated for almost 500 degrees as housing. I don't see how it's plastic, but okay, that's what they said. And the probes are high temperature also, unlike some other brands that's probes cannot take over about 300 degrees. They will, these are supposedly good for 500 or something like that. And they ain't expensive on Amazon. I'll put a link to the Amazon site for the Smartro, and they make several different models. But this one, I think I already said, does not have an app for your phone. So let me get my ribs seasoned up. Okay, here we go. So do rinse them, because they cut them in half on a bandsaw. I don't know why didn't peck-a-headed butchers think you got to cut these damn things in half. Give me the whole bone. I like salt and pepper only, like I said earlier. You don't have to try to worry about removing the membrane, just bite around it, like biting around a bone. You can chew on it if you want to, but don't swallow it, unless you're a dog. Okay, let me flip them over, do the other side, and go get them out on the smoker. I see enough there for me to eat. I don't know what Miss JB gonna eat.
We got our little side baskets here, and I'm just gonna put some newspaper down in the bottom of them and light it on fire. Come on, rumple up and get in there. There we go. That's good. Where's my lighter? Okay, here we go. We're lighting the newspaper on fire. Fire, boy, fire. Want to eat, you gotta make a fire. That's the number one rule of all the wind blowing today. Uh-oh. Another method here. That's good enough. And just set this down on top of it. There we go. Light. You can also rumple that newspaper up and put it in some paraffin wax, some melted wax, and or tie it with some twine and then dip it in some paraffin wax. Makes it even faster, lighter. Got a little kettle right here. And this one's got the flip-up things on it, which was optional. I'm gonna go ahead and take that off so I can set one of them trays down on the side, right under one of these things here, so I can add more charcoal if I need to. Chimes sound good, huh? Sure do. I built them. That's why. They big. See? 6 foot tall or better. Okay. I went ahead and put my grate on there, and I done cleaned it. And dropped that in there. And I grabbed it with channel locks. Don't pick this thing up when it's hot. It got the paper in it right now. Don't pick this thing up hot with your hand. You'd be mad as hell with yourself. And I'm gonna put some hickory on there in just a minute. Let it light a little better. And soak that wood first too, because you grill it and it'll just poof, ignite. Well, we're gonna be choking the air back on here. So it ain't gonna really just go poof. But I'm gonna lay the meat over here on this side. Okay, cut, wool halt. So here we got a soaked wet piece of wood. And I'm not even gonna bother to put it down on the bottom, unless I put it right there. That's plenty good enough. Let's get our meat. And put it on there. Kinda like that. And right there like that. No. Uh-oh. Look, we got an impasse here with the probe, huh? Okay, well, we don't want to get too much closer with that piece of meat. So we'll have to regroup this probe. I'll just stick it in some more. Let me just put this right here for now. Oh, it's round. It's holding. Good. Stuck it all the way through. I knew that was going to happen. I see a problem with this and this type of meat. So we just do this. We come in the other way. There we go. We good. Get our lid. And just lay it right on top. Open the air and we'll monitor the temp. There we go. I can see one probe is sticking through and it's in the air temp. I mean in the on the fire. See, it instantly went to 165. So we just shut it up. So it, in other words, it stuck through the meat, but I ain't gonna mess with it. I just leave it alone. To hell with it. Turn this off. It's working though. You really need a thicker piece of meat to use something like this, like a butt or a brisket. You can't really use it in ribs, but I just figured I'd demonstrate it. And it'll stick right there, and supposedly it won't melt. I wouldn't put it over the fire, though. There you go. It's ready. sell a pullback, that's what you really go by. You don't go by no time. You want some pullback on them. It'll probably still be a little bit rare, maybe not much. We'll see. See, that's the bottom side. You want to see the flip side? Bam. Dead of business side, right there. Ribs. Eat. As you cut through that, there's an odd bone in the back. So you really got to kind of take your knife and maneuver through it like that, see? On the back side. On the other ones, it's just going to go right through. And this is a buck knife. And they hold the edge. It has the other side of the other ones. I know I'm in a light. They hold the edge very well. And they're, just, and they're hard as hell as sharp because it's hard, hard steel. It's gonna go straight through here, and this knife is not that sharp because I use it on metal like you see me doing now. Oops, almost dropped it. I'd have ate it though. That is right there. Took about 3 hours, 2.5, somewhere in there. Came out perfect. Delicious, tender, not too greasy. Also made some fried green tomatoes, which go great on burgers. I just had them with this and the sides that you see. You can also light your fire with these. They're cheap. This worked great. Easy to use. Try it. It's a great little entry-level thermometer, and you really need one for smoking. Link in the description box. Try them. They work. They're simple to use. A boy, a girl, a buy it.